In this video, we'll consider a circuit in which it contains a dependent source, and we will use Laplace transform method to solve for Vc of t. Okay. So in this, we have a voltage dependent current source. 1.5 V1, where V1 is the voltage across 2 ohm resistance, and initial voltage is already given, Vc of 0 minus is 11 volt, and you have to get an expression for Vc of t. Okay, so what we will do now, we will write frequency domain equivalent circuit, and we will replace each component here, and we will write its frequency domain equivalent representation. Okay, so we know that a capacitor with initial voltage can be represented either an impedance in parallel with a current source or an impedance in series with the voltage source. In our this problem, it's better if we have a impedance in parallel with the current source. Okay, so we will use the second one we will use, and direction of current, you see that it should be upward. If I of s is forcing like this and V of s is like this, the current source will be in this direction. Okay, so that one we have to take, and it is C into V of 0 minus. So let us first write equivalent. One is resistor will not change, it is as it is. And again, how to write this dependent source? See, dependent source, it's in time domain, it is 1.5 V1. It is similar to independent source, but it is controlled by a voltage across somewhere else. So 1.1 V1 in the time domain, it is controlled by 1.5 into V1 of t. But in frequency domain, it will be 1.5 V1 of s. So it is controlled by V1 of s. So V1 of s, if you calculate, that is controlling this magnitude of this current source. Okay. So that is how you write a voltage dependent current source in complex frequency domain. It is still voltage controlled current source, but that voltage is now in Laplace domain. Okay, so that is the only change, and this will not change, and this voltage, what we call it, is not V1 simply, it is V1 of s in frequency domain. Okay, and now this capacitor is replaced by an impedance, and it is also associated with a current source face in the direction of the arrow mark is upward, and this impedance is 1/sc. What is the capacitance? 2 milli. So 2 millifarad. So it is 2 milli. Okay, and this one is C, just see here, it is C into V of 0 minus, C into V of 0 minus, where C is 2 milli and V of 0 minus is given in the problem, that will be 22 milli. Okay, so now we have drawn this circuit in complex frequency domain. Now let us simplify this current or voltage equations, and we'll get the expression for V1 of s. So which one is better here? Since it has current sources, we will use KCL here, or nodal equation, and we will call this node as node 1 and this node as node 2, and we will write two nodal equations, and we will solve for V1 of s. We want Vc of s. Where is the Vc of s? This one is better to write here. It is Vc of s. Okay, Vc of s we want. So nodal equation at one. Okay, so what are the at one, what are the current, one current, leaving current, that is V1 of s by 2. So we will write V1 of s by 2 plus V1 of s minus V C of s, or V of s, V C of s, V1 of s minus V C of s divided by 1, okay, equal to 0. So this, if you write, if you simplify, this will be 1.5 times V1 of s minus VC of s equal to 0. This is equation number 1. Now nodal equation at 2. So at 2, nodal equation, one incoming current is this one, that is 22 milli. 22 milli, that is equal to, one is VC of S, current flowing through capacitor, voltage divided by impedance. Impedance is 1 by 2 milli S plus 1.5 V1 of S. Next one, current leaving from this node is done. Now we have to write current leaving from this node. Sorry, this branch we have calculated. This branch we have to calculate. So that is plus V phi of s minus V1 of s divided by 1. So this one, you simplify. So what you get in this, it is, we have one equation where variables are V1 of s and VC of s. Now this case it will be 0.5 V1 of s and plus VC of s. To just simplify this, I'm directly writing here 2 milli s plus 1 equal to 22 milli. You solve this, you will get, you simplify this, you will get this equation. So we have two equation. One is 1.5 V1 of s minus VC of s equal to 0. Another one is 0.5 V1 of s plus VC of s into 2 milli s plus 1 equal to 22 milli. So if you solve these two, solving 1 and 2, solving 1 and 2. Okay, but we are not interested in V1 of s, we are interested in VC of s only here. So VC of s expression will be 66 milli divided by 6 milli s plus 4 you will get. So this, if you further simplify, this will be 11 divided by 1s plus 666.66 you will get. So that, if you simplify or if you find inverse Laplace transform, it is VC of t equal to 11 e power minus 666.66 t you will get. Okay, so this is the solution for this problem.